Imagine stepping into a pod in Mumbai at 9 a.m. and arriving in Delhi in time for a 10:30 a.m. meeting. Not flying, traveling on land at nearly the speed of sound. Sounds impossible? Well, what if I told you that India is not just dreaming about this future, we're actually building it? Welcome back to Postbox Trends, where we decode the future before it arrives. Today, we're diving into one of the most ambitious transportation projects in human history, Hyperloop, India. This isn't just another tech story. This is about India potentially becoming the first country in the world to make science fiction reality. By the end of this video, you'll understand why global experts believe India might just leapfrog everyone else in the race to revolutionize travel. So buckle up. We're about to travel at 1,200 kilometers per hour through the future of Indian transportation. Before we talk about India's Hyperloop revolution, let's understand what exactly is Hyperloop technology. Picture this. A sleek, aircraft-sized pod gliding through a near-vacuum steel tube at speeds exceeding 1,000 kilometers per hour. That's Hyperloop, often called the fifth mode of transport, after walking, cycling, driving, and flying. The magic happens through two key principles. First, magnetic levitation, the same technology used in Japan's bullet trains, but supercharged. Powerful electromagnets lift the pod completely off the track, eliminating wheel friction entirely. Second, the near-vacuum environment. By removing 99% of the air from the tube, air resistance, the biggest enemy of high-speed travel, virtually disappears. It's like creating a controlled environment similar to flying 200,000 feet above sea level. The result? Travel speeds that make our fastest trains look like bullock carts. While India's Vande Bharat reaches 180 km per hour, and Japan's Shinkansen hits 320 km per hour, Hyperloop promises speeds of 1,200 km per hour. That's faster than most commercial aircraft. This concept was reintroduced to the world by Elon Musk in 2013, but here's the fascinating part. The original idea dates back to 1799, proposed by British inventor George Medhurst. Sometimes, the future just needs to wait for technology to catch up with human imagination. Now let's talk about why India desperately needs this revolution. Picture this reality. Delhi's average vehicle speed during peak hours is just 20 kilometers per hour. A 10-kilometer journey that should take 30 minutes often stretches to over an hour. We're literally crawling when we should be racing toward our economic goals. But speed isn't the only problem. India houses 21 of the world's 30 most polluted cities. Our transportation sector contributes 14.2% of Delhi's total air pollution. That's more than the famous stubble burning that gets all the media attention. Every day, 2 million Indians face premature health risks due to air pollution, much of it from our archaic transportation systems. Consider the Mumbai-Pune corridor, one of India's busiest routes. By car, this 150-kilometer journey takes 3.5 hours on a good day. By the fastest train, it's still 2.5 hours. For a route that sees 75 million passenger journeys annually, expected to hit 130 million by 2026, this inefficiency is not just inconvenient, it's economically devastating. Here's the shocking truth. Traffic congestion costs Indian cities billions of dollars annually in lost productivity. When vehicles crawl at 20 km per hour instead of 60 km per hour, they consume 48 times more fuel and produce exponentially more pollutants. We're not just stuck in traffic, we're stuck in the past. India's urban population is set to reach 600 million by 2031. Our current infrastructure is already buckling under pressure. We need solutions that don't just move people faster. We need systems that can handle massive capacity while being environmentally sustainable. This is where Hyperloop enters the picture, not as a luxury, but as a necessity for India's survival as a modern competitive economy. Here's where the story gets exciting. While the world debates whether Hyperloop is possible, India is actually building it. At the Indian Institute of Technology Madras, something historic happened in December 2024. The Avishkar Hyperloop team, consisting of 76 brilliant undergraduate and postgraduate students, completed India's first Hyperloop test track, 422 meters of pure innovation. This isn't just Asia's longest Hyperloop facility, it's currently the world's longest operational Hyperloop test track. Union Railway Minister Ashwini Vaishnaw made a stunning announcement. After two grants of $1 million each, we're approving a third grant of $1 million to IIT Madras. Once we see commercial viability, we'll start our first commercial project of 40-50 kilometers. Let me put this in perspective. While Virgin Hyperloop shut down its passenger operations in December 2023 after burning through $450 million, and while other global companies struggle with funding and feasibility, India is systematically building from the ground up with government backing. The projects are jaw-dropping in their ambition. Mumbai-Pune corridor, the crown jewel. This 150-kilometer route could reduce travel time from 3.5 hours to just 25 minutes. We're talking about a system that could handle 75 million annual passenger journeys, growing to 130 million by 2026. Vijayawada-Amaravati, a 40-kilometer test case in Andhra Pradesh that could be completed in just 6 minutes compared to the current hour-long journey. Chennai-Bangalore, the tech corridor connection, 350 kilometers covered in just 30 minutes instead of the current 56 hours by road. The funding model is brilliant. This isn't just government money. It's a three-way collaboration between Indian railways, private companies like L&T and ArcelorMittal, and international partners including Swiss company SwissPod Technologies. Even steel magnate Lakshmi Mittal is personally invested, providing 400 tons of specialized steel for the test facility. And here's the kicker. Tutor Hyperloop, a startup incubated at IIT Madras, just conducted India's first commercial intent Hyperloop pod run. We're not just testing technology, we're building an entire ecosystem of innovation. Now, let's address the elephant in the room. If Hyperloop is so revolutionary, why hasn't anyone built a full-scale system yet? The engineering challenges are mind-boggling. Imagine maintaining a near-perfect vacuum across hundreds of kilometers of steel tubes. Any tiny leak could cause catastrophic pressure changes. The pods must accelerate smoothly to Huawei 200 km per hour without making passengers sick, then decelerate just as smoothly. The financial reality is sobering. Estimates suggest India's 40-kilometer test track will cost about $150 million to $300 million. A full Mumbai-Pune system could require investments of $215 billion. For comparison, India's bullet train project between Mumbai and Ahmedabad costs $17 billion for 508 kilometers. But here's where India's unique challenges come in. Land acquisition, the graveyard of many Indian infrastructure projects, becomes even more complex for Hyperloop. Unlike railways that can curve around obstacles, Hyperloop tubes need relatively straight paths for optimal efficiency. The regulatory framework is virtually non-existent. How do you regulate a transportation mode that doesn't fit existing categories? Is it like aviation, with strict safety protocols? Or like railways, with different operational standards? India's regulators are literally writing the rulebook as they go. The international track record is concerning. Hyperloop 1, despite raising $450 million and conducting successful tests in Nevada, never achieved commercially viable speeds or economics. Virgin Hyperloop's first passenger test reached just 172 km per hour. Impressive, but nowhere near the promised 1-200 km per hour. Critics argue that for the cost of one Hyperloop route, India could build extensive metro networks serving millions more people. Others point out that our existing infrastructure projects, like the Mumbai-Ahmedabad bullet train, are already years behind schedule. However, here's why India's approach might be different. Unlike private companies chasing quick returns, India is building systematic expertise through IIT Madras, creating a knowledge base for long-term development. The government backing provides stability that private ventures lacked. The question isn't whether Hyperloop faces challenges, it absolutely does. The question is whether India's methodical, research-driven approach can overcome them. But let's imagine for a moment that India cracks the Hyperloop code. What would that actually mean for our country and our lives? The economic transformation would be staggering. The Mumbai-Pune Hyperloop alone is projected to generate $36 billion in socioeconomic benefits over 30 years. We're talking about time savings, emission reductions, accident prevention, and operational cost savings that compound into massive economic value. The job creation potential is enormous. Construction, operation, and maintenance of Hyperloop systems would create hundreds of thousands of high-tech jobs. But more importantly, it would position India as the global leader in Hyperloop technology, creating export opportunities for our engineering and manufacturing sectors. Think about how this would reshape Indian cities. When you can live in Pune and work in Mumbai with a 25-minute commute, the entire concept of metropolitan areas changes. Housing prices could equalize across regions, reducing urban overcrowding while developing smaller cities. Tourism would be revolutionized. Imagine a Golden Triangle tour where visitors could see Delhi, Agra, and Jaipur in a single day, spending more time experiencing culture and less time traveling. The domestic tourism market, already worth billions, could explode with such connectivity. The environmental benefits are game-changing. Hyperloop systems are fully electric and can be powered entirely by renewable energy. A single Hyperloop route could reduce carbon emissions by 150,000 tons annually, equivalent to taking 30,000 cars off the road permanently. For business, the implications are profound. Agricultural products from Punjab could reach Mumbai markets within hours of harvest, reducing waste and improving price stability. Manufacturing could decentralize, as companies wouldn't need to cluster in expensive urban centers for connectivity. But perhaps the biggest transformation would be India's global standing. The country that successfully commercializes Hyperloop technology becomes the world's transportation technology leader, attracting massive foreign investment and brain talent from across the globe. This isn't just about faster travel. It's about reimagining what India could become in the 21st century. So when will you actually be able to board a Hyperloop pod in India? Let's break down the realistic timeline. Phase 1. Current, 2024-2026. We're here right now. IIT Madras is expanding their 422-meter test track to nearly 50 kilometers, which would make it the world's longest Hyperloop test facility. This phase focuses on proving technical feasibility and safety systems. Phase 2. Demonstration, 2026-2028. If tests succeed, expect the first demonstration route, likely Mumbai-Pune, to begin construction. This won't be full commercial service, but paying passengers might experience limited Hyperloop travel. Phase 3, commercial launch, 2028-2032. Full commercial operations on the first route, followed by rapid expansion to other corridors. The funding strategy is crucial. The government has committed ₹834 crore, about $1 million initially, with promises of more based on results. But the real game changer would be international investment once India proves the technology works. Learning from the Mumbai-Ahmedabad bullet train experience is critical. That project, announced in 2017, won't be fully operational until 2028, an 11-year timeline. Hyperloop needs to prove it can be faster in deployment, not just speed. The risks are real. Technical failures, cost overruns, or regulatory delays could push timelines by years. However, India's methodical approach, building expertise before scaling, might avoid the failures that plagued international Hyperloop ventures. Conservative estimates suggest a 60-70% probability of seeing operational Hyperloop service in India by 2030. That might seem low, but consider this. No country has achieved this yet. India has the potential to be first. So, let's return to our opening question. Is Hyperloop India the future of travel, or just an expensive dream? Here's what we know. India has the infrastructure challenges that make Hyperloop not just useful, but essential. We have the technical expertise through IIT Madras and the government backing for systematic development. Most importantly, we have the desperate need for transportation revolution. The engineering challenges are immense, but so is putting humans on the moon, building the internet, or creating smartphones. Every transformative technology seemed impossible until someone made it work. While other countries debate and private companies fail, India is quietly building the expertise and infrastructure that could make us the world's first Hyperloop nation. The 422-meter test track operating in Chennai is not just steel and magnets. It's the foundation of a potential transportation revolution. In 10 years, you might be watching this video while commuting from Pune to Mumbai in 25 minutes, or traveling from Chennai to Bangalore faster than you can currently cross a typical Indian city. The future doesn't announce itself. It's built by countries brave enough to invest in impossible dreams. What do you think? Is India ready for Hyperloop, or should we focus on fixing our existing transportation first? Drop your thoughts in the comments below. Are you excited about the possibility of Hyperloop travel or skeptical about the timeline? If you found this deep dive into India's Hyperloop future fascinating, smash that like button and subscribe to Postbox Trends for more stories about India's march toward tomorrow. Hit the notification bell because our next video will explore India's space economy, another area where we're quietly becoming a global leader. Remember, the future belongs to countries that build it, not just dream about it. And right now, in a laboratory in Chennai, brilliant Indian minds are building what could be the future of human travel. Until next time, keep trending toward tomorrow.